Okay, we are going to start filling up our database with the data that we received from outside. And before we do that, we need to make sure that we are in the right project. So go to NodePoint, project identification, and see if it's the right project that is the active one. NodePoint terrain model, so this is okay. Usually when you put in data into the database, it is from a DVG file. And this is the case in your project and in the future projects, at least on this school. There are many other possibilities to import data. It could be XML, DSFL, and so on. But in this case, we will concentrate on DVG files. In the last video, where we did a validation of our three-dimensional data, we saved our validated data, and we need to open this DVG file to import it. It's found under TMUD. This is where we saved it after validation, 3D basic data. And this is the file, or these are the data that we need to import. To import a DVG file, go to NovaPoint, terrain model, and import from current drawing. Then you get this dialog box, and the important thing here is that we are in 3D mode, and then we need to establish a new group within the database. We activate the three dots and we get access to the database system. And the database is constructed or structured with groups from 1 to 10,000. And before you start importing data, it's important that you decide where to put the different types of data. Usually from group 1 to 10 we put the stuff that we get from outside, being the three-dimensional data that we are going to import now, and from 10 to 40 we save the calculated terrain models. From group 1000 to 2000 we save our centerline data, and from 2000 to 3000 we save our 3D calculated road projects. But in this case, it's an external data source that we are importing from, so we make up a new group starting with 1, and be specific and precise when you write what's going to be in the group, just so that you can find it later on. Like this. The default values for status, type, priority, and level are the ones that we use, so don't change any of these. Okay, we have now created an empty group, 1, where we are going to put in our 3D data, the validated 1, and we press OK. Now to go on from here, you press Proceed. OK means end, so this will just stop the import, but proceed and select all the items that you want to import and enter. The layer names in this drawing could have been paired with a specific feature code in this SOSI feature code set that we are using, but there is no match, so in this case all the data will be put into feature code 999, and that's okay. Okay, and it will now import. Look down here in the corner, see that all the entities are saved. Now to be sure that we have something that we can use inside our database, we will have a look at the graphics in the database. Not something that we usually do because it requires a lot of calculations and time, but let's have a look. NovaPoint, terrain model, and view edit, the barrel with the magnifying glass. We will then get a graphic view of the database, and we can see that our data have been imported, and in our view mode we choose height map so that we can see the coloring of the different levels, and it looks fine. Had there been any mistakes or non-valid levels in the data, this would all be one color, and you would need to validate your data before importing. But this is okay. This is what we need to calculate our terrain model, being the grid model or the triangular model. And this is the next step in the process.